First, let's pay to the lineage gurus homage to the Venerable Monk Liaoming, homage to Master Sakya Dzogchen, homage to the 16 Dharma King Karmapa, and homage to Master Dzogchen Dorje, homage to the three jewels of the altar, homage to the main deity of Homa today, the High King Kuan Yin Bodhisattva. Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma lecturers, Dharma assistants, temple directors, and all disciples present here and over the internet, and our participating VIPs today from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs Secretary General's wife, Dharma Sister Judy. Accountant at the Tribhuta Foundation, Dharma Sister Teresa and her husband Larry. CTI TV Taiwan producers for the Geni Dian Sang Xin Teng, Dharma Sister Rebecca Xiaqi. Assistant to the former Vice President Li Xiulian and also the PR Director of International Businesswomen Association, Ms. Chie Huiling. Sunny line dancers from Taiwan, Dharma Sister Lin Yixuan. And from the Fuxing Airline, Dharma Sister Wu Meixian. The former director of the Overseas Credit Warranty Fund's wife, Ms. Dharma Sister Vivian Shit, Dr. Ryan Zhuang. Good afternoon, everyone. How do you do? Next Sunday, on August 9th, is the Mahachakra Homa Fire Offering Ceremony. Mahachakra in Tantrayana is very important, very famous. Why? Because you can empower yourself. So if the place you are doesn't have a guru, then you can empower yourself. So you can pour this water on top of your own head. As long as you can make the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas to enter into the bottled water, so that the water merges with the lights of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and then you use it to empower yourself, then there would be self-empowerment, that the empowerment is not done by another guru. And you need to recite the Mahachakra mantra a number of times, because Mahachakra has the power to invoke all the Buddhas or Bodhisattvas to empower you. So you empower and transmit to yourself. This is how great Mahachakra is. And some people say that that Mahachakra is a manifestation of Sakyamuni Buddha, and some said that Mahachakra is a manifestation of Maitreya. And Maitreya is the future Buddha, that at the three meetings of the dragon flowers, that with one statement, Namo Buddhaya, that you can go to the Pure Land, that Maitreya Buddha will save trillions of people. So Mahachakra is an emanation of Maitreya. If you think that you're Buddhist and I don't want to wait until the three meetings of the dragon flowers, I want to have attainment now, that's good. But if you cannot, then you wait until the times of the three meetings of the dragon flowers with one statement, Namo Buddhaya, Maitreya would be able to deliver all sentient beings in these three meetings. So if you are willing to attend the three meetings of the dragon flowers of Maitreya, then you need to be the primary supplicant for this Mahachakra Homa. If you don't want to attend a meeting where Maitreya would use such a special Dharma method and really swiftly and easily save you, then you don't need to become the primary supplicant. And if you are the primary supplicants for the Mahachakra and receive the empowerment, you can self-empower yourself if you do not have a guru in the place, at your place. Say if you live in Cambodia, in a remote places, very far away places, like in the North Pole or South Pole, or Africa, where there are no tantric vajra masters there, then you can self-empower yourself. And after you become the primary supplicant and receive empowerments from Mahachakra, then you can empower yourself. The supplicants are important. That's the introduction for Mahachakra, the main deity of Homa, next Sunday. And today we had the Homa of Haiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva. And our Haiking Kuan Yin is different from other people's. Other people's Haiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva is wearing the five Buddha crown, but our Haiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva is wearing the seven Buddha crown. So most tantric practitioners would have their own lineage gurus on top of their heads, and Grandmaster has four lineage gurus. Every time I would say homage to my lineage gurus, the Venerable Mang Liao Ming, so he's on top of my head. Second, Master Sakya Zhenkong, the Zhong Rinpoche, as my lineage root guru on top of my head. And third, the 16 Dharma King Karmapa, also on top of my head. And fourth is Master Dukden Dorji on top of my head. So four tantric lineage root gurus on my top of my head. So Guan Xin Bodhisattva never forgets about the seven Buddhas, so that's why there are seven Buddhas sitting on top of her head. And the mantra, that's the mantra for the seven Buddhas, the seven Buddhas empowerment mantra, abiding or sitting on top of your head or her head. And her mudra is the Dharma teaching mudra. In the Dharma teaching, outer Dharma teaching mudras, either one. The only mudra, inner and outer Dharma teaching mudra. And she's truly majestic and beautiful. And the sutra, as I have said before, hiking Guanyin Sutra, I was at the Yihuang Temple, the Jade Emperor Temple in Taizong, after Golden Mother opened my divine eye. And the Jade Emperor Temple is a Taoist temple, and the main deity is Indra, or the Jade Emperor. But the abbot was an ordained Buddhist monk, and his name was Si Hui Ling. Si, like Sakyamuni, Si, Hui, meaning wisdom, and Ling, spirit. So he gave me a sutra to recite. So I brought it home. When I opened it, it was Hiking Guanyin Sutra. So Hiking Guanyin Sutra was the first sutra that I ever came across in this life. And I memorized the Hiking Guanyin Sutra. There's no need to talk about how responsive she is. These few days, there was a disciple from New York. And she is suffering from big problems. There are two big problems in America. One, after immigrated to America, the first problem that you would encounter is green card, your residency and citizenship. And after you got them, the second biggest problem would appear, and that's paying taxes. When you see an IRS letter, a letter from the IRS, you would start having headache. And that my sister Teresa would know that when you are audited by IRS, that was really a big headache. So there are two major issues living in America. One is your status, your citizenship or residency, and the other one is tax. But you know, after reciting Hiking Guanyin Sutra, it would be easy for you to get your residency or citizenship. And also, it would be easy for you not to be audited. Or even if you are audited, then you could resolve soon. So when Grandmaster was about to get the green card, you know, I recited the Hiking Guanyin Sutra. So Master Lian Huo, Lian Si, Lian Zhu knew about this. The lawyer who helped me with my green card was called Henry. And he is still an immigration lawyer now. After I filled in my application, the lawyer sent it in just by regular mail. So it'll take 7 days before the letter gets to Washington, D.C. or the Immigration Department headquarters there. and another 7 days for the letter to come back. So at least 14 days. But after the letter got there, they don't respond right away. You have to line up. And you know, the letters pile up really high. There was a lawyer that went into the immigration office and took photos of the documents. And the application forms was really high. A reporter took the photos. And if it falls to the ground, it's like huge pile. And sometimes you have to line up for a long time, several years sometimes. You know, so the time for the mail, 7 days out, 7 days back, and then waiting to be approved, that would be a few days, or at least a few months, right? But for me, it only took 11 days. Nobody had that happen to them before. So the three brothers knew, 11 days. It took me 11 days. But normal mail usually would take 7 days going there and 7 days coming back, at least 14 days, right? Because for the ordinary green card applications, they just use regular mail. So how could it all be done in 11 days? So maybe the letter was attached to an urgent mail and got there in a day. And my documents was also quite thick because there are lots of forms for the immigration. So do you know, when this thick document, when they got it, because there are lots of documents piled up already, lined up, but maybe inadvertently it was placed on the top of the pile. And the immigration officer maybe was in a good mood that he had a good time last night. And that day, maybe he got promoted. So he was in a good mood and was really happy. And he didn't even examine it and sign it right away. And maybe the letter got on a somehow jet plane coming back. So from filing the application until I got my green card, it took only 11 days. You know, the efficiency in America was always delayed.
Always wrong. Always mistake.
That's the efficiency in America. And the letter returned to me was addressed to the wrong address. There was no such number. I was living in Ballard on 10th Avenue. The number was 7573. And the letter was addressed to 95-something, that there wasn't such number. So they changed 7 to 9. But the good thing, the postman, I say hi to the postman often. So they knew, he knew who I am, Sung Yan Lu, because we said hi to each other. So he noticed that this is a letter addressed to Sung Yan Lu, but not to that number. So the postman brought it to me personally. So it's so accurate. So hiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva was really responsive. So after getting my green card, when it was time, it's time to get my citizenship. I could only memorize one sentence, I like America. I like American. So that's all I memorized. At that time, we didn't have to memorize a lot. And then I got there to the immigration office, and they tried to find my documents, and they couldn't find it anywhere. And the immigration officer told me that we couldn't find your documents. I knew that ahead of time. So I prepared my own the duplicates, because it's always a mistake. All my records, my applications, everything was gone. They couldn't find it. And I prepared a set. So, and I gave it to them. Now I could take the test. Because the three brothers also knew the immigration officer. So they asked him to ask the easy question, like for kindergarten. So let me ask you the first question. How many states in the United States of America? Do you know? 50. Hawaii was also one of the states. And who is the current president of America? The first. The first president of America, George Washington. And then let me ask, and they asked me the capital, and I said Washington, D.C. And then he said, oh, you're so smart. Actually, I wasn't. The capital, the president, and how many states? Which state do you live in now?
Washington State.
And I said, of course I know, Washington State. And what's your name? And family name, first name, family. Of course I know that. Sung Yan Lu, so I pass those five questions. So can you write in English? So I like American. So I passed. So that's the benefit of reciting Haikin Kuan Yin Sutra. It's fast. You pass the test with flying colors. When I took the driving test, I also recited the Hiking Kuan Yin Sutra to help me. There was the written test first. So Hiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva helped me because I didn't know everything was in English. But now they also have Chinese language and other languages. But at that time, there were not very many immigrants in Seattle. At that time, when we heard someone else speaking Chinese, we would feel really close to them. So the way I took the test is like this. Right, true here, false there. And then I just throw the pen, true, false. And then the multiple choices. And I also passed with flying colors. I was helped with Hiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva. So the Hiking Kuan Yin Bodhisattva has great power. And then the road test, the driving road test. You know, at my home, we have lots of letters because there are a lot of disciples who write letters to me. So that's why the postman knew me. And at that time, the correspondent office was only me. I was the only one replying, writing replies to the letters. So every day, I send letters. But Simu was very smart, and she always passed tests. So I never was in any training. And without license, I only drive from my house to the post mailbox. So every day, I would drove twice, going to the mailbox and then coming back. And sometimes when I parked on the side of the street, sometimes the wheels would get on the sidewalk. So when it was time to take the test, they told me 10-mile stop, change lane. And parking, parallel parking. And then backing into the garage. And parking. And then stopping on a slope, the wheel has to. And then if it's a slope downward or upward, the wheel is just turned toward the sidewalk. And the officer from the driving the driving's office, and I spoke English to them.
Please say slow. 还拽张那 picture， 啊，拽张的这个 picture 就是我画了，啊，我画了很多的图。What kind you like？ What kind you like？
You I draw a lot of pictures and then ask, because I did not understand what they're talking about, like parallel parking or parking on the slope, downward slope or upward slope, backing into the garage. I wouldn't have understood the English. And they spoke it differently, so I just showed the pictures, and he said, this is the first time that someone draw that. So he felt really happy. And then he said, this one. Ten-mile stop or whatever, based on the picture. And I got 97 out of 100. So I was helped by hiking Guan Yin Bodhisattva. It had never happened before that someone would draw pictures. And could you please tell me which one you want? I was the only one, right? Right? And the most interesting one was the written test. I prayed to Hiking Guan Yin Bodhisattva by throwing the pen. True or false? Choice number two. That's how I took the written test. But it's so accurate, so responsive. So Grandmaster Lu had been living in America for over 30 years. And my English is still not good. But
the gas station, the gas, buy the oil, buy the gas, buy gas. I can. Go to the supermarket, buy the food, or buy 什么东西，这个都可以。这个，我除了这个以外，
But other than those, driving,
那不用讲，自己有房子了。
Living, of course, I live in my own home.
坐巴士还可以。
And I know.Riding on a bus and sleeping, of course, that's easy. I am not lazy. When I get up, I would make my bed. I'm not lazy.I'm not talking about this Yixian Dharma sister, but another Yixian, Erica. She lived in Limbo Villa, and she lived at the Limbo Temple, Limbo Villa then. And I checked on the rooms, and I saw the blanket was being kicked away. Why don't you fold your blankets? And she said, well, because we're sleeping again at night. There's no need. Just kick the blanket out when she got up. and at night she pulled it back. But for us, we would fold our blankets every day and make our bed and the pillows and pull the sheets and whatever we need to wash and to clean it. Otherwise, it would be like a pigsty. So, Erica, what's your habit these days? Do you make your bed? Yes. It's hard to believe. There are a lot of ladies that they look really beautiful when they get out, but in their own rooms, it'd be like a shipwreck. Hiking Guan Yin Bodhisattva is very responsive. So many, many people reciting Hiking Guan Yin Sutra, and by completing 1,000 recitation, all calamities would be eradicated. At that time, we changed this. But in the sutra that was we added, if you're not fortunate or that you don't believe, then you would have the response. You specially recite the sutra. But then we changed it into that if you're fortunate and you're also sincere, then you can recite this. So the fortunate and with great faith that you would be recite the sutra. See, Chinese is like this. Chinese is amazing. Songhua. Zhonghua is Chinese youth team. Win over the Korean team. Or in Chinese, if you say the Chinese youth team lose or beat the Korean team. So Hiking Guan Yin Sutra is the same. So whether you believe, you have faith in her or not, whether you're fortunate or not, it is all the same, very responsive. So once you get the response, then it would generate faith in you. That's why I urge you to recite the Hiking Guan Yin Sutra. And moreover, True Buddha Sutra is also very responsive. It's just that you don't know. True Buddha Sutra is also a very responsive sutra. So that's the responsiveness of the Hiking Guan Yin Bodhisattva. And truly, it can eliminate all kinds of sufferings and afflictions. And you can recite until the end, you would bear Sariras, that the translator's Haniva's father only recited Hiking Guan Yin Sutra, that during cremation, he bore lots of Sariras. So the Hiking Guan Yin Sutra can eliminate all kinds of sufferings and even the suffering of birth and death. in the great perfection Dharma Humil. Oh, in practicing Trakchul, first we need to have the notion that wisdom is the wisdom and prajna of enlightenment that is already embodied in each being. Wisdom does not come from the outside. Each individual has a Buddha nature. Sentient beings were originally Buddhas. Therefore, wisdom should come from our own mind. The Buddha once taught Ananda, let yourself please, irrelevant of others. Actually, even in taking refuge, we take refuge in ourselves. So wisdom doesn't come from outside. That every individual has a Buddha nature, wisdom doesn't come from the outside. So sentient beings were originally Buddhas, therefore wisdom should come from our own mind. The Buddha once taught Ananda, let yourself please, irrelevant of others, that actually in taking refuge, we take refuge in ourselves. When you recite, we said, we take refuge in ourselves. So, we take refuge in the Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha. And the daughter was asked, what kind of color dress would you want to wear? And she said, I want to wear a color that match my dad's hair. And then Lily replied, oh, well, I want to wear white because my dad's hair is white. And then I heard somebody cried out. And because she said, oh, but my dad is bald. It's okay. You can wear a skin color dress. What's so big deal about it? So you need to be creative. What's that? Which one should I use? A married friend had his or her own saving, and I asked, after a few years, I asked him, how did you do it? And he drew a deep draw of the smoke, and every time I hid the savings, I would put a note that this money is for my wife's New Year's bonus, or this is to buy her birthday gift, and this is for Valentine's Day. So if my wife found out, my wife would be happy. Hey, man, you should learn from this. Before, in Taiwan, Grandmaster hid some private money, but not in America. In America, Simu, my and Simu's money are the same. My money is Simu's, and Simu's money is my money. And it's not. My money is Simu's money, and Simu's money is Simu's. Then that's not right. But before in Taiwan, I like to hide some private savings. It's a habit that I cannot change, that in America, you know, I I find that it gives me more freedom if I have my own savings. So the places I hid my savings in Taiwan was not known by anybody. Only I knew. You know where I hid them? Behind like the board. It's like placards with great writings on it. You know, endowed with wisdom and compassion. Or with great transcendental power. So I hid my private stash behind the boards. And then I tie a red thread around it. And the red thread would be showing under the board, because you don't need to touch it, because you have to climb on a chair to get on there, because they're all high. But I could see the red threads, a very fine thread, only I would know, nobody would notice, then I would felt good that, oh, they're still there. But do you know that Simu found out? Because Simu also had her own private stash. She used an old newspaper to wrap a stack of bills, and she was trying to find a place to hide it. And she thought, oh, behind this board would be the best place. And so she got on a chair and then pushed in, and it felt something is in there. And so she found my private stash. Right? Did it happen? And Simu said, I pretended I didn't know. And she put back my stash. So she has good conscience. See, she didn't cry out loud. She just quietly put them back, and then she just used them when she needed it. So wisdom, where did wisdom come from? It's from your own mind. That your mind, wisdom would naturally appear from your mind. So you would hide your wisdom inside a place that nobody would know. Like, say, I hid it inside the old stack of old newspapers. And one day I went out and I checked, the old newspapers were all gone. Oh, don't scare me. The stack of old newspapers were all gone. So I was really panicky and asked my family. And they said, oh, we use it. Oh, we burn them into the fireplace for the winter. Oh, we have lots of responses today. So they burned in the fireplace and it's gone like that. I couldn't sleep that night. You know, I had to do it in the middle of the night to go there and then make sure it's there before I go to bed, before I would be able to fall asleep. You know, by touching the pile of money, I felt good. And now it was gone. So that night I lost sleep. That they burn it, they use it as like a waste paper. They have no wisdom, only I have wisdom. Prajna and Buddhi already embodied in each being. Wisdom doesn't come from the outside. And this Buddha nature is forever, it's always there, it cannot be stolen, it cannot be burned. It will not be attacked by water or fire. Everyone has a Buddha nature and you need to develop your own Buddha nature. And that would be the Buddhist, a true Buddhism. You cannot develop other people's Buddha nature, or vice versa, other people cannot develop your Buddha natures. So you can only liberate or salvage yourself. The true statement is that you save yourself, you deliver yourself. Look at the sixth patriarch, Hui Neng. At that time, when the fifth patriarch, Hongren, taught him the key formula and asked him to leave. And the two of them were on the boat, and the fifth patriarch was about to paddle the boat. And the sixth patriarch said, "Let me do it myself." "Why?" the teacher asked, and the disciple replied, "When I was still deluded, I need to be delivered by my teacher. But when I'm already enlightened, then I can save myself. I can deliver myself." And this is also what the Buddha taught Ananda. Let yourself please, irrelevant of others, of course, you deliver yourself. You don't need others to deliver you. And in taking refuge, we also take refuge in our own Buddha nature, and that's called the self-refuge. This is very important. This is not a real joke. Woman is like a tree, and man is a pig. Never hope that pigs can read, or woman is books, and the man are pigs. So the pigs can never read books, which means man could never understand the hearts of women. For this mundane people, it's very difficult for them to gain enlightenment. Why? Because they have so many external temptations. When you gain enlightenment, then you deliver yourself. At that time, man and woman are books, and they understand themselves. Uh, The Vajra name for the 16 Dhammakinkamapa is the Vajra who understand his own mind, which means he was enlightened and he comprehend how to deliver himself and to deliver others. So for human beings, it is most important to understand your own mind. The wife got home and went into rage to the husband. Did you have, in Chinese, it's like, did you have an affair with my secretary? And the man said, yes, you agreed, right? You approve. And she said, bullshit. Yeah, I asked your secretary. This is a coarse word.
Huh? 老公讲我问你的秘书小美能不能
ask your secretary, can you? And the reply was can. This joke cannot be told. It's a dirty joke.
有一个人去买车,
someone went to buy a car and the price was $80,000. And on him, he only had $2 less, $79,998. So he went to the beggar outside the shop. Could you please give me $2? I need to buy a car. And then and the beggar gave him $4 and said, can you buy me one too? So this is the question about wisdom. The devil asked God, can I be reincarnated? And God said, yes. And the devil said, I don't want to become a devil again. I want to become like an angel with fair white skin and with wings. But I still want to draw blood. And then God said, okay, go ahead, be reincarnated. And ever since, mosquitoes exist. So we've told the jokes. Think about it. Every one of us, according to the Buddha, everyone's Buddha nature needs to be understood first. If you understand your own Buddha nature, then you take refuge in your own Buddha nature, which means you have true understanding of your own mind. And then you cultivate spiritually based on that understanding. And then once you have attainment in your spiritual cultivation, then you have the fruition of your Buddha nature, and that means you attain Buddhahood. The key point of the Great Perfection Dharma is that you want to make your own Buddha nature into fruition, but and not to have it be buried in there and not discovered.